Welcome back. Today's headlines of CCTV's News Bulletin are Chemical in the Americas 2018's welcome reception, an interview on Latin America, and to start with some sound bites from yesterday's seminar on the amended TSCA.
In today's seminar on TSCA, amended TSCA, we learned that there is a lot of work going on right now with the EPA, but there's also a lot of work that needs to be accomplished. There's also an interaction with the manufacturers and the processors that is so critical for EPA's doing the work. We also learned that there was just the beginning of the reset. We think of it as the reset ending on February 7th, but that's only for manufacturers and importers. The processors have their chance until November when the final list comes out for the inventory reset. There were a lot of questions and a lot of great questions. One of them that comes to mind is that prior to the reset, there were 86,000 substances on the inventory. Last count in early February, the EPA states that there's 62,000 chemicals now listed as active. There will be some substances that are duplicates, but that's quite a large number, but at least the EPA feels it's at least a more accurate number. What surprised me was that the work that we're doing for all of the risk assessments needs to be interactive. Maybe I wasn't surprised by that, but I think it's a good thing to realize the EPA doesn't come out and promulgate something and then we say we don't like it. We as chemical manufacturers, chemical importers, or processors have an obligation to work with the EPA so that we can get accurate assessments of our chemicals.
It's time to learn more about the welcome reception. Hello, Ron. How are you?
Hi, TJ.
Ron, yesterday we talked about your father, Joe Jones. He was a true legend of rhythm and blues, and he started the career of many. Did he also teach you how to play the piano?
Oh, absolutely. Many lessons from arrangements to theory, lots of stuff he taught me. In addition to that, Fats Domino also taught me a few lessons at home, showed me how to play some of his songs, which was great. And I didn't know he was Fats Domino at the time, but he was Fats Domino.
If we show the impression of the welcome reception, could you play Fats Domino's famous song, Walking to New Orleans?
Oh, absolutely. This time I'm walking to New Orleans. I'm walking to New Orleans. I'm gonna need two pair of shoes when I get through walking these blues. The welcome reception was at the Presbyter located on the northwest side of the Jackson Square. The Presbyter was designed in 1791 to match the Cabildo, or town hall, on the other side of St. Louis Cathedral. It was built on the site of the residence, or Presbyter, of the Capuchin monks. While intended to house clergy, it was never used as a religious residence. In 1834, it became a courthouse, and in 1911, it became part of the Louisiana State Museum. The Presbyter has two permanent exhibits telling two sides of the ongoing Louisiana story, but more about that later. Many delegates were pleased to catch up with each other during the evening's event in this historic house.
Today's interview will take us to Latin America, where we learn about the recently established Latin America Regulatory Cooperation Forum.
As you know, in Latin America, we have trade blocs, Mercosur and the community. However, chemicals management was never part or not usually part of these discussions. The aim of our forum is to engage the industry in those discussions as one of the main stakeholders to contribute to good practice and regulations that are consistent with the society and the resource of those countries.
Roland, do you think that DHS harmonization is possible in Latin America?
I think DHS by nature is not as harmonized as we would think or as it is written in the book. Mm-hmm. I think we see the example of CLP where we, I would say, have the only harmonization as good as it gets. Latin America countries are pretty much all of them aligned with the Purple Book.
Which
between one and six. And so They are aligned in most of the aspects. Many of them refer directly to the Purple Book, but we clearly see local differences. And I think we will always have them over the next few years.
What is the strategy of the forum to enhance regulatory cooperation in the region?
The most important part of our initiative is to strengthen the dialogue between industry to industry, government to government, and can have a common forum of discussions, especially in the next year that we are building those regulations, because we know after the regulations are in place, it's much more difficult to make them compatible or harmonized.
You can watch the complete interview on our YouTube channel. Time for the statement of the day. Today with Robert Haminiak from SOCMA. Robert, welcome.
Thanks, happy to be here.
Robert, recently Hurricane Harvey had a big impact on the Houston area, on chemical companies there. Were they prepared?
They were absolutely prepared. It was very challenging, but one of the things that they did and did particularly well was they got in touch with the local emergency responders. They made sure that police and firefighters and all those folks were prepared for what was going to happen. So they did a great job of that communication, and that helped immensely. There was another big challenge, which was the supply chain. We did see some disruptions, you know, going all the way up the East Coast. That was combined with the fact that Hurricane Irma hit just a few weeks later. So there were some impacts there, but again, the industry really did a good job of responding and overcoming that challenge.
And your statement is?
The chemical industry is prepared for future natural disasters.
Great statement. Please let us know what you think about it. Robert, thank you very much for your statement and support.
Thank you.
New Orleans knows hurricanes all too well, despite the fact that the founding father of New Orleans, Mr. Bienville, wrote, when he discovered a crescent bend in the Mississippi River, it feels safe from tidal surges and hurricanes. But in 2005, New Orleans was hit by the Hurricane Katrina. It resulted in one of the worst disasters in American history, leaving 80% of the city flooded and hundreds dead. Ron, can you tell us about this catastrophic chapter in New Orleans history?
Well, of course. Pictures of TJ say more than 1,000 words. Tell me what's happening down in New Orleans. The clouds came in, it started to rain. It rained real hard for a long, long time. 6 feet of water in the streets of Evangeline, Louisiana, Louisiana. They're trying to wash us away. They're trying to wash us away.
You can learn more about this story of rescue, rebuilding and renewal of New Orleans at the Presbyterian's exhibit Living with Hurricanes, Katrina and Beyond. Now it's time for the forecast. The forecast for our first conference day of ChemCon the Americas 2018 features an impressive lineup with authority representatives from Brazil, Colombia, Argentina and Canada, including Mexico and emerging chemical control legislation in Latin America. A very exciting morning, I would say. In the afternoon, a roundtable on trends and issues on risk management. And after that, we put our spotlight on the USA, more Tosca, but also California, followed by a perspective on nanomaterials, both in the USA as well as in Europe. Thank you for watching and enjoy your day.